So I just finished the first day of advent of code. Let's take a look at the solution and walk through it. So if we come here, this is day two. Let's go back to day one. And the problem is, so something is wrong. Okay, we're not going to read the whole story. Basically, you have this document, right? And you need to take each line and turn and basically get the first and last number. So one and two. This becomes 12. 3 and 8 becomes 38, etc. In this case, tribu 7 Shay, the first and last is 7, so 77. That's the weird part. So then you add all of them together and you get a number. Okay. How did we solve this? Let's take a look at the code. So if we open the challenge here, what do we have? So I started with tests actually. So here in the tests, I had a sample. I just copied this. And I just described my test suite. So if we fold this, this is my trebuchet project. It should turn each line into a two-digit number by taking the first and last integer to occur in the line. So we expect this, with the sample data that they gave us in the problem, to equal this, right? The sample data being, this thing here. So we literally like took, where's the challenge? We took this and turned it into this. That's it. And this function, of course, didn't exist, but we filled it in later when the test was failing. So what is this function doing? Well, we get the calibration doc, which is this. We end up pre-process. We'll talk about that later. But we split by a new line. Let's ignore this. And then what we do is we match the digits, all the digits. G means match all of them. Then we map over them and turn them into numbers. Then the first number is obviously this. If there's no first number, we just error. The last number is the last element of this array, which if there's still one number, like tribu 7 Shay, like this, then the first number is 7 because it's the first, and the last number is also 7 because it's the only one in the array. And then we return it. And this actually works because our tests pass. Okay. But then there's a second, and then of course we have to sum it. So we have another number called sum, another function called sum all numbers. And it gets an array of numbers and just literally just like reduces over them and sums it. And this works. So the answer was 55172 and it worked. But there's part two. It looks like some of the digits, what's wrong with my font size? Some of the digits are actually spelled out with letters. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, such that this 219 needs to be 29, not 1, right? And so we have some more input data, some more expected output data. We feed them into our tests. That's sample two, is basically this. And the test is this one. It should replace textual representations of numbers with their numerical counterparts. So we have a function called turn words into digits, and it turns this into well, something like this, right? And then if we turn it into something like this, such that 219 is like that, then the answer from this function, the previous one we just wrote, would be 219, and then 9 would be the last, etc. So we want to test the synergy between these two, but we want to also test this one in isolation. Okay, turns out it works. Let's look at the implementation. So what we're doing is we have a partial line which is empty. We split this, so 219, we split that into characters, and for each character we push it into the partial line. And then we check, okay, is there something here that we can replace with a numeric counterpart? So we just literally go like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This is probably ugly and doesn't and can be done more elegantly because it's like pretty automatic. Some would say this code is not very dry. That is, don't repeat yourself. In fact, if we look at it like this, yuck, look at that. There's probably a more elegant way to solve this problem. But it works and it's covered with tests. So the tests pass. I can just go in and change it anytime. This is the beauty of test-driven development. Okay. So let's continue here. So let's go back to our, what is this? This is a new window. Okay. So now we return the partial line. So we push into the line. As soon as the line matches one of these, we replace it, and then we keep doing that for each character. We return it. Again, it works. And then, of course, business as usual, we then sum them in the past, like we did in the past, right? And that's it. And then we push it into the test and so on. And it just works. Now, a problem with this is that There's one thing that the test didn't tell you, and here I'll show you. So this rule, A3 needs to become, let's go look in the test. It needs to become 83. And this is a huge problem, because you would end up with something like this if you were naive, and then there's no 3 here, you know? So accounting for this case was why I had to do this, instead of like, my initial approach was to have like some type of number map, like an object with, on the left-hand side is the character representation, so O-N-E for one, on the right-hand side is the number, and then I iterate through that. But if you iterate through that, 3 comes before 8. So it would be E-I-G-H, and then the number 3, because of the order of iterations. So if we come here at like NPM, NPX, vitest, that is to run the tests. Yeah, it all passes. And indeed, I did solve the puzzle. So I got 2 gold stars. It was fun. Thanks for watching. Let's solve the next one, maybe live.